We're just 2 weeks away from the Personal Fitness Expo and the World Bodybuilding Federation Championship. Looking forward to it.
Personal Fitness Expo and personal appearance is really nice to be in top of. Vince McMahon, you ought to be there, and I'll tell you about how to cover your rug.
Thank you very much. I've always wanted to know that. We've got an Oriental one there at the house that needs covering for some time. But right now, on his way to the squared circle, someone who doesn't need to cover anyone up unless there's a little dirt he's going to cover you with. Look at that ugly.
Yeah, that's why they say stay away from strangers, kid.
This man means business, folks. He's a real downer.
There's a chill in the air.
Kidding, man. Give me a little happy tune, you know. 99 bottles of milk on the wall.
Even little Hulkamaniacs stand in awe.
I knew that would happen. Yep.
What's that thing that he hands the referee there?
That's the urn.
Oh, what's mine is urine. Is that what that is?
That's a water under the bridge as far as I'm concerned.
Oh.
We had an occasion to speak with Mr. Paul Bearer a little bit earlier on before the broadcast. Here's what he had to say.
The ultimate warrior. Very few human beings have experienced what you have and have returned to talk about. Next time, you won't be so lucky.
You can bet that the Ultimate Warrior doesn't want to wind up in the urn, being ashes in the urn, that's for sure. What a matchup, though, that's going to be. The Ultimate Warrior against The Undertaker, and there is some speculation as to just how much psychologically the Ultimate Warrior was impaired as a result of being closed in that airtight casket.
So why is he calling for the thing there? Why does he need that?
If you watched him, it almost seems like he derived some sort of power from it. It's very,
And it's full of, I know what he's, it's full of what?
I don't know what it's full of.
We don't know that, I see.
Full of anticipation of who the next victim is.
Whoa,
right
look at
there.
That.
You cannot deny that The Undertaker is a phenom, and the Ultimate Warrior is going to feel the wrath of The Undertaker.
And vice versa. The Undertaker has never.
I've never heard of a wrestler named Vice Versa.
No?
No.
Well, you heard of one called the Ultimate Warrior.
Listen to this sick puppy.
Oh, wait a minute. Whoa! And down on the tombstone! After that, look at that man.
The Undertaker just beat Vice Versa.
Oh, baby.
Yeah, he likes it when it's all over, doesn't he?
Liposuction, huh?
That could have been the Undertaker just as easy as that.
I mean, it could have been the Ultimate Warrior instead of The Undertaker.
Oh, you might be right about that.
Since you retired, I think some of them bifocals might come in.
Yeah, here, try them on. See what's...
I don't want to buy the bifocals, I'm going to rent them.
The body bag being brought into the ring, and what an unceremonious way to lose a match, being placed in a body bag.
What is this poor guy's...
I can't fathom imagining the Ultimate Warrior winding up...
What is this guy's parents, this guy's family thinking about what they're doing to him right
parents.
Now? His family, everybody that's watching. I mean, you're putting a... Look
Listen,
at that.
He's a television
putting,
star. He's got no gripes.
You're putting a guy in a
He should
bag.
Be happy right there. The Undertaker, a phenomenal mood. This guy has got ability. You cannot deny that. And this is the tombstone. His head bounced a foot and a half. Could have been even more.
He's got ugly, too.
The Ultimate Warrior is looking forward to the opportunity of taking care of The Undertaker.